Well, welcome to another video, and in this one I'm going to be talking about constellations. So what better place to do it than with Orion behind me? If I step to one side, and hopefully the focus is going to get it. So Orion is probably the best known constellation in the night sky. It sits down on the equatorial equator, which means both the north and southern hemispheres can view it. Pretty much everyone on planet Earth at the right time of the year can see this constellation. But why do we have constellations at all? We see these stars grouped together in what seems like patterns. Some of them are laid out in straight lines. Orion, for example, has three stars in the middle in a very straight line. Why do we get these patterns? Well, the answer is that it's just random. Now, it might not look random when you see it in the night sky and you have what seem to be shapes laid out, but this is exactly what you'd expect from purely random star positioning. So there's no particular meaning to any of this. Let me illustrate. I'll generate a random star field. So let's take a cube of space and we'll fill it with a couple of thousand randomly placed stars. So the position of these stars inside the cube is completely random. And now if we go into the middle of that star field and look around, you can see that the stars are not really evenly spread. You can see that they're clumped together in places. Some of them even seem to be laid out in straight lines. But this is exactly what you'd expect to see with purely random positioning. If you never did see stars clumped together, that would not be random. Okay, so now let's look at the actual real constellations in the night sky. So when you look up at a constellation like, say, the Big Dipper or Orion, the constellation might appear to be some kind of thing out in space, an object that you could actually travel out to. But often the stars in a constellation might not actually be anywhere near each other. It could just be that they're kind of lined up from where we're standing and appear to be close together. So what we'll do, we'll take a look at some well-known constellations and kind of rotate around them and see whether they really are close together or not. So let's start with the Plow or the Big Dipper. This is a very well-known constellation in the northern skies. And if we rotate from side to side, you can see that the stars are, well, they're not far apart, but they're not laid out quite how they look from here. As soon as you move to the side, the whole shape of the constellation changes. Okay, let's take another northern skies object. This is the Pleiades or Seven Sisters constellation. They're quite tightly clumped together. And if we take a look at this and rotate around it, you can see that they really are clumped closely together. So it's not just that they appear close together from where we're standing. They're part of an open cluster. It's a small region of space where stars are being formed, and they really are quite close together. Okay, let's move to southern skies now. And a very famous constellation in the southern hemisphere is, of course, the Southern Cross. But the stars in this constellation, well, as you'll see, if we move from side to side and rotate it, you can see that they're not really that close together. One in particular is a lot closer to us than the rest. The constellation only appears the way it does when we're in the right position on Earth and seeing them all laid out in a particular way. But anyway, let's go back to the constellation that I started with, Orion. Now, the stars in this constellation really aren't close together. If I rotate it, you can see that they're quite stretched out along our line of sight. Some of the stars are relatively close by, whereas others are really far away. So as soon as you rotate this constellation, it kind of disappears. It only has the pattern that we see it from when we're here on Earth. Okay, so we're on Earth looking up at these constellations, but is it possible that somewhere out there, if there really is extraterrestrial life, that maybe someone is looking up at a constellation in their night sky and one of the stars in that constellation is our Sun? Could this be possible? Well, it's actually very unlikely. You see, our Sun is quite a dim star. It's a yellow dwarf star. It's a good thing it's dim. Dim stars live longer, and that's good news for us. This means that it's very difficult to see if you're not quite close by. Let's look at an example. Remember the Pleiades or the Seven Sisters? We're out at the Pleiades now and we're looking back in the direction of the Sun. So if we move to one side, the Sun is in the center of the screen, but it's just too dim even to be made out. and the Pleiades aren't that distant. So, no, it's unlikely that anyone's looking up in the night sky at a constellation and our sun is part of it. It's just too dim. Okay, that's all for this video. See you next time.